One of the three key components for exposure in your camera is the shutter. The shutter sits in front of the chip and behind the lens, and there's a series of curtains. The first curtain goes, followed by the second curtain, and the amount of time that that stays open is the amount of exposure that the chip receives. Longer shutter speeds create blur. Faster shutter speeds freeze action. To give you an example, we came out here today and I was photographing some water. Now, on a quick exposure, like 125th or 250th of a second, we're able to freeze some of that action. But once we slow the shutter speed down to about 1 second, you can start to see the blur that gets caused by keeping the shutter open. As long as the shutter remains open, it records everything that happens in front of it. This includes the movement of the water and my movement. This is why it's important to use a tripod for long exposures. The general rule of thumb for being able to handhold an image is this. If you take one and you put it over the focal length of the lens that you have, for example, with my Tamron 18-270 lens, at 18 millimeters, I should be able to handhold at almost a 15th of a second. At 270, I need to be at 1/250th of a second to successfully handhold an image. This is because the zoom magnifies the image as well as my movement. But some rules are meant to be broken. If you have a lens that has stabilization, something like Tamron's VC technology, you're able to successfully handhold an image at almost 4 stops beyond what the rule says.